The episode of singer Kanika Kapoor has raised all sorts of questions over whether hundreds of people may have been exposed to the possible infection of the coronavirus. This emerged after photographs in which Kanika Kapoor can be seen partying with Member of Parliament Dushyant Singh. After Dushyant Singh, it emerged that Derek O'Brien, the Trinamool Congress leader in the Rajya Sabha, sat next to Dushyant Singh for 2 hours at a parliamentary meeting, after which he too went into self-isolation. The UP health minister was among those who also possibly was exposed and has had to undergo self-isolation as well. This raises all manners of questions over whether we are still underplaying and undermining how dangerous this is and whether community spread may actually be taking place as we speak. Derek O'Brien, who's gone into self-quarantine, is joining us now via Skype. Derek, obviously, we can't meet you in person because you're in isolation, so technology helps. How you're doing, first of all?
Completely no symptoms, asymptomatic, as my doctor wife would tell you, but asymptomatic. So, but it's still important that I do this isolation and the self-quarantine. It's important. And actually, you know, the focus is not on which public servant is on self-isolation. The focus, I mean, the message we have to give across, send across to everybody is that you got to stay away from crowds. You got to stay in small groups. That is the main thing which is happening, because that's how this will spread. But I'm really saddened to know that in Parliament, we've been trying the last almost more than 1 week. You know, I'm sorry to report that people are not rising above politics. This is not a political issue. We are in a global, not even a national. This is a global health emergency. And if you look at some of these things which have been happening from the senior most MPs of the ruling party and the way that the house is being conducted in Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, why? We are 10 or 12 days defer Parliament. We're not saying this today. I've been saying this now from the 10th of March. But everyone thinks this is some political stunt or political gimmick. It's not. This is a global emergency. Please defer Parliament.
What response did you get? What response did you get when you tried to raise this? Because I was tweeting nonstop saying, why is Parliament functioning if board exams are being suspended? What was the response of the leadership of when you raised this, of the government?
You see, around about early March, I'll tell you, Parliament restarted on 2nd or 3rd of March. My colleague, Sudeep Bandyopadhyay, who is my counterpart in Lok Sabha of Trinamool, and I'm in Rajya Sabha, we had a chat with Mamata Banerjee. And Mamata Di herself was, you know, she told us, you know, why do you guys want to go to Delhi? Think about, that was early. I'm talking about for 1 week in March, the first. But then we said, no, we'll come. So when we came to Delhi, and then what happened is, I think it was Monday. I forget the date, but it was Monday. I think it must have been the 15th. If 15th was a Monday, maybe 16th. It was Monday. I gave a 0-hour notice saying no politics. I want to demonstrate in Rajya Sabha. I want to show in just 120 seconds to show how to wash your hands, to spread, you know, with soap and the different ways of washing your hands and doing this and doing this, you know, that kind of thing. My gosh, I was told no hand gestures. You can't allow this. No hand gestures. Please stop it. Speak. So I put the hands like this. I put my hands like behind my back, you know, to make my point. But everyone is getting very touchy. What is the idea of the cover-up? That's the first thing. Then the week before that, what happened in Parliament, the Parliamentary Affairs Minister went into self-isolation, Muralidhar, because he was in Rajya Sabha. He came into contact with, he went to a hospital in Kerala. And he had a meeting with Shukendu, in my colleague in Parliament, the chief. So Shukendu himself also was not keen to come to Parliament. Now, Muralidharan went to self-isolation. So Suresh Prabhu is in self-isolation after he came back. But Suresh Prabhu didn't come to Parliament. So he was in self-isolation in Bombay. Now, that's when we thought we should express ourselves. I don't know if I wasn't allowed to show the demonstration. After that, what happens? A phony machismo on a health issue. Then, on the 17th, on the 18th of March, two of us, or maybe three of us, including Shukendu Roy, who had an interaction with Muralidhar, and I had a mask. See, my wife is a doc, so she was also giving me some advice. My doctor here was also advising me, Dr. Chandran, said, no need to wear a mask. But once we heard about this, it's more like safety. Then what happened on the 18th of March, we were ordered to leave Rajya Sabha because three of us were wearing masks. Why? Then I must give credit where it's due. The Ambaram from the Congress benches, it's four seats away from me. He got up, and because he advised to say that, listen, if two or three members are feeling vulnerable, please allow them to wear the mask. So then it went on. You know, then it went on. Now, 18th afternoon, so that was in the morning. Again, it was bulldozing by this government. Prison, when we're saying it's not a political issue. Now, what happened on 18th afternoon, there was a big meeting, which I had requested for in writing on the 5th of March, saying call a meeting of the tourism committee, call a meeting of the aviation committee, or the standing committee, call a meeting. Now, chairman goes and calls a meeting after 2 weeks. So he calls a meeting on 18th. Now, when 18th of March, Dushyant was sitting on my right, and on Dushyant's right was Sonal Mansingh, and I had no clue that, you know, Dushyant had gone to Lucknow, or there was a singer in Lucknow. We had no clue. So that's 18th. Now, by the way, let me tell you, on the 18th of March at that parliamentary standing committee meeting, the first thing I said is that we made a request for a meeting on the 5th. You've called a meeting on the 18th. By the way, the chairman is from the ruling party. I'm telling you the story, and thank you for interrupting, but it's important people to know this, that on the 18th, I said that this meeting should have been held on video conference because there were 70 people in that room. Aviation ministry was there, rail chairman and his officials were there, tourism ministry was there, and Dushyant was there. So there were about, I counted in fact, that's why I said, and I was the only guy with my protective mask. Now, that's what happened. And then we all went away. Then yesterday afternoon, I went in the afternoon to Ambedkar statue in Parliament. I went there to shoot a small video. In fact, trying to say that defer Parliament, what are we discussing in Parliament? That's the time when I was walking back, and you have to cross the journalist thing there. That's the time, the tent. And then two of the journalists told me, you know, sir, Dushyant has come into contact with that singer from Lucknow. And that's the time I came home and consulted my wife, who's a doc, consulted my doctor, Dr. Chandra, and they said, please don't take any chances. Follow protocol. You must follow the protocol. That's the story. But it's not my story. This is not important about an MP. What about the 3,000-4,000 other people who are exposed in Parliament? The security guards, the support staff, the media, the message you're giving, it's all confused messaging. It's all cross messaging. One side you're saying that don't meet in groups. One side you're saying don't meet in groups. Then the other side you're saying no, Parliament will run. Why will Parliament run? Cock and bull reason. Cock and bull reason. Why will Parliament run? Because we have to show the country that we are the soldiers leaving from the front. No, you're not soldiers, nor are you doctors. So let the MP should have been allowed to go back to their states. What are you discussing in Parliament? What are you discussing? Yesterday, what was being discussed in Parliament? Whether the word in the private member's bill, whether the word socialism should be removed from the constitution, or the Sanskrit university can be set up. All this can happen. Pass the finance bill. It should have been passed last if they had taken Trinamool's advice and then sent all the MPs home.
Derek, it's very, very disturbing to hear this, especially when you focus on what was being discussed. But who would you blame for this? And the reason I ask this is because other parties have also shown, a kind of cavalier attitude. For example, I was observing Shashi Tharoor's son, Ishan, tweeting him, finally trying to put public pressure on him, saying, Shashi, stop being such a boomer, stop attending Parliament. Did Parliament collectively undermine the gravity of this? Yes, you fought for it, but I didn't see too many members of Parliament joining you or supporting you. So, can you blame the BJP alone for this?
No, I don't want to blame at this hour of a national health emergency. I don't want to blame anybody for anything. What has happened has happened. If somebody didn't take it seriously, they didn't take it seriously. The BJP senior ministers were getting up, maybe because the two of them, their two bosses had told them to do this. And this is the typical brazen it out or bulldoze. But I will I restrain myself from making any political comments like that, yes. But, you know, it's, I don't want to say I told you so. We told you the same thing at monetization within 1.5 hours. Mamta ji had tweeted and said, we saw this draconian decision. So I don't want to get into the politics. Leave the politics out. Come on, Monday, now you've made enough mistakes. Now don't show any more dadagiri, please. We need to fight this together. We will overcome this together. Don't show any more dadagiri. Now, on Monday, please pass that finance bill, which you could have passed long ago. You don't even have to bring it to Rajya Sabha because it's a money bill. Get it over with on Monday, please. No, not about victory for Trinamool or Mamta Di, nothing. Just do this. Now, let's leave. In the past, I was sitting next. Who do I sit next to in Rajya Sabha? You know, the average in Rajya Sabha is 64. On my left is Uncle Pawar. He's 80 years old. I advised him. I said, Uncle, please don't come to Parliament. Please. Then on my right is Professor Ram Gopal Yadav. He's 74 years old. What have we, you know, and I can understand if you're coming there to discuss, you know, some, what are you discussing? And I'm not even saying cancel Parliament. No, just defer it. And when the situation gets better, 10, 12 days. Now, I'm in self-isolation here, but I'm worried because my senior, my colleague in Lok Sabha, Sudeep Da, he hasn't gone back because we needed to have Lok Sabha leader here and Rajya Sabha leader here just to keep. Now, he's almost 70 years old. I'm going to get him back on a flight. Well, if not today, certainly on Monday. Enough is enough.
Now, tell me something. Let's just go over. There's a fantastic kind of graphic in the newspapers this morning that actually explains how one person can create the havoc that has taken place. And if you go down the graphic, you see it's not just Dushyant and then you sitting next to Dushyant at a meeting. It's also the UP health minister. The UP health minister then goes on to meet the chief minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath. And the Times of India on the 20th of March reports that Yogi Adityanath went and took the UP report card to the Prime Minister. We already also know that the President met with Dushyant at a breakfast that you were also invited for, but you didn't go to. So we're actually talking about Parliament being exposed. Possibly if Yogi Adityanath has been exposed, then he's met the Prime Minister after that. And the President, of course, who's cancelled all public meetings since then. Why did you not, how did you happen to not attend that President's breakfast, which according to me should have also not been taking place?
Well, personal call I took. There again, I've got to give credit to my 24-year-old daughter and my wife. They said nothing to me, you can't go. So I didn't go. It's not once he invited me on the 13th of March and I regretted. And it's the highest constitutional authority. And on the 18th, I didn't go for the same reason. But you know, Barkha, I don't think this is a situation now to discuss about. This is not the story about for me. Let me also use this into your chat, since I'm in conversation with you, to see what is happening. You know, we can self-isolate, sit at home, do a Skype interview. What is happening to those people who are living 7-8 people in one room? The messages we have to get across to them, you know, like, for example, the first thing is that please stay at home. It's very, very difficult. Like, for example, here also, even I'm seeing something, but I'm wondering whether I'm practicing what I'm preaching, because upstairs, we're asking people to stay at home. Yes, the maid who works with us, I mean, her family, they're like family, her spouse and her kid. Three of them are here. They're not coming down, but they're in one room upstairs. There are 40 crore, maybe more Indians who live in single rooms. We need to be looking at these issues. We need to be communicating and telling people, please don't travel at all. Ghar pe reh jao. Now, if we need to be telling these people, and don't go to hospital for a test. Ye mat kijiye. Otherwise, everyone will go to the hospital for tests. When I called up Dr. Chandraya, he said, no, don't come for a test. I don't have a kit. Private doctor has not got it, those test kits. So we don't want people to be landing up in hospitals. I am spending the whole day today, WFA, working from home. All I've been trying to do is to get information from the West Bengal government, from the chief minister's office, from our own social media team, and sending out public service messages. I would appeal to all MPs, leave your party flags out, forget about parliament. Get out these messages to appeal in your constituency. You can do that sitting in your constituency and follow the basic rules. I think this is a bad example. And Parliament giving us this completely, totally wonky logic. We have to stand there. We have to be like the helper. You're not. Let the health workers do their job. You know, I always believe that the cricketers do their job also.
Yeah, but let me ask you something though about Bengal, your the state that you represent. There was also a very, very senior bureaucrat who showed exactly the same sort of irresponsible behavior, sloppy behavior that we saw by singer Kanika Kapoor. And according to me, the parliamentarians who were partying with her, the bureaucrat should have been much more careful. What do you have to say about how the bureaucrat, the senior bureaucrat in West Bengal government behaved? By again, not being cognizant of how she was exposing other people.
I am bound to answer the question. I am bound to answer and I will. But since you mentioned the singer and one or two MPs who were like, who was there at the party, etc. Fine, you can point a gun at them and shoot them. But what about the other senior most parliamentarians? What about the Prime Minister? What about the Home Minister who are allowing Parliament to run? That's an answer I want. Okay, now I'll come back to Bengal. Yes, I mean that bureaucrat should be, I'm telling you, I know how angry and how furious the chief minister was. I don't want to disclose a personal telephone conversation. Completely furious and it's completely unacceptable. As we said it, there is no VIP here. There's no very important person. There is an LIP, we're all LIPs, you know. In fact, when the Delhi police, I've written to the Delhi police and said, don't send the security guards to my house. I have security, I said, not needed. My doors are shut. I'm okay. I'm safe inside. Please don't send unnecessary, whatever the two guards they have to send every day or the not necessary. So I think that case was terrible. And being a senior bureaucrat is completely unacceptable. Set a bad example. But having said that, Bengal, the way, the compassionate way, and the very, you know, in a straight, what's the word I'm looking for? Compassionate and giving clear direction. Whether it was two, three nice ideas. The first idea which Bengal came out with, I think many states, and Kerala have also done some good stuff. And Maharashtra also doing some good stuff. So this is not about brownie points. But two, three ideas. One is the corpus which was set up of 200 crores. And now corporates are going to be also putting in funds for this emergency fund. One, two. The health insurance, 5 lakhs extra for health insurance professionals, not only in government hospitals, but also in private hospitals. That is important. That's a good sign. What about 8 crore people get rice and atta right up to September for free? So at least basics, I mean, whatever basics, and the communication has been good. We've also stopped interstate bus services. The chief minister, I just tell you, it happened half an hour ago, maybe 1 hour ago, has written to the railway minister saying, please stop trains going into Bengal. You know, these are all the, we're all trying to do this together. The other point, I think.
No, one minute. Let me come in on this distribution of the rice and the potatoes. There is Swapan Das Gupta of the BJP who has gone on Twitter to say that this is the Mamata Banerjee government completely undermining the Prime Minister's Janta curfew. There will be a rush and a crowd to collect this rice, the rice that is being distributed. And this is actually irresponsible because it leads to crowd gathering. And it is being done on the same day that the Prime Minister has called for a citizens' curfew. Do you not think, because you've said throughout this conversation that we must rise above politics, that as Indians, one, we are headed for a prolonged lockdown. That would be my guess. And I think tomorrow's a trial. And I think that we all need to get used to it and cooperate with it. So how do you respond to this charge that you have, or your party is undermining the Prime Minister's people's curfew?
No, we're not undermining any curfew of anybody. I'm not going to make a specific comment about what one nominated member of the Rajya Sabha said or didn't say, who unfortunately politicizes everything, becomes Bengal-centric, but that doesn't matter. That's his right. But what I want to tell you is that the ICDS idea of using the ICDS to get free stuff across to the kids. That was Bengal's idea, and that was done before the announcement on the announcement which was done by the Prime Minister. By the way, I am in all this rara about the Prime Minister's announcements, I have two suggestions to make. Yes, this shutdown of 14 hours, why weren't the chief ministers? It might have been a good idea if it's a true federalism. You announce everything and then have the video conference. I'm very clear how this should have been done. This should have been done. First, have a video conference with the chief ministers. You would have got some ideas. Then you have your address to the nation. But this federalism has gone out of the window. So number two, there are states which had already planned stuff for Sunday, and the ICDS was planned for Sunday. Now, what do you do? Don't give the children or give the children. So you can't have your, you can't have.
I mean, can't you shift it by a day? Can't you shift it? Can't you shift it by one day? Can't you shift it by one day? Can't you shift it by one day? Can't you shift it to Monday instead of tomorrow? Like,
I'm sitting here in Delhi. There must have been some logistical issue, but no one is doing. See, listen, everybody else, when the BJP, etc., you know, they bring out these tools. Mamata Banerjee had announced his ICDS. I know, I tweeted this out because I got it from the CMO 3-4 days ago, before the Prime Minister's thing. Why are we making these little issues? What about the, all the, why are we making issues out of this? There are one or two, Bombay and Delhi based MPs of the BJP whose job is to sit down and create the confusion. Let them go now and find out what is the reality in Bengal and how Mamata Banerjee is leading this effort. And I must say one thing. So I have a serious question to ask. Why did the, listen, it's a national emergency. Now, you guys want to do, if the ruling party at the center want to do dirty politics, what can I do? I don't want to do dirty politics. We said, we fight this together. Why didn't the Prime Minister? What was the issue? If the Prime Minister, before going to SAARC and giving SAARC 75 crores of rupees, see you, get me started, I'll tell you all. Prime Minister, did he first have to go to SAARC and then go to the Chief Minister? I think chronology...
Derek, I got the broad point you wanted to make, but in the end, I want to actually share something with you. You spoke about or you referred to testing. Today, I learned from one of the top global experts that there is actually a second way, a quicker way of doing these COVID tests. It's to test for antibodies instead of the genetic testing, which is much more elaborate, more accurate, yes, but also takes much more time, and we have a shortage of kits on that. So if Parliament is indeed functioning, I hope your party and all parties are going to press for more testing, and I'm going to send you the details of this test. I hope all of you will raise your voice for more testing with this simple antibodies test that frankly I didn't even know about till today.
Okay, let me answer that in two parts. Firstly, Parliament ran in both houses for 110 hours. Out of those 110 hours, less than 3%, can you imagine, less than 3% in Parliament of the time was allotted to discuss corona. The rest of the 97%, don't ask me what else was discussed, but this corona was 3. Now, what will be discussed in Parliament, not discussed, I really don't know, because the Trinamool Congress may want to take a call. We'll take a call tomorrow, whether we will, because we've been pushing hard on this, whether we will go to Parliament in the first place. Enough is enough. We have to draw the line somewhere. We'll have to find some other method maybe to get our voices heard. Because in Parliament, it's being muzzled.
Okay, we'll have to leave it there, Derek. Stay safe. And we all have to find productive ways of keeping ourselves busy. Because I do think we're all headed towards social distancing and some form of social isolation. Thank you very much. And thank God for technology that still makes it possible for us to be talking to you. Thanks, and look after yourself.